Good afternoon, everyone. Good afternoon, everyone. Yeah, wish you a happy Independence Day. If you all can hear me and view me well, so just type a yes so that we can start with today's session. Welcome, everyone. I can see a long list coming up. Hello, hello. Just type a yes or a hello so that I get to know how many of you are here with me. So if you can hear me and see me well, please write a yes. Okay, Sahej. Thank you so much, Sahej. Okay, so rest assured that you all can hear me and see me. I welcome you all to Athral Studio. And as we all know, we are on our Kalamkari course, and today we are going to do a beautiful painting of a horse. Animals, birds, and humans, these are the main subjects of all the drawings, most of the drawings, and few of the animals are mostly seen in different kinds of art forms. So here we would be starting with the horse. Symbolically, horse shows speed, bravery, and valor, and that is how it is most appreciated. And now today we are going to do it in a Kalamkari style. So all the sessions have passed by. Yesterday in our live session, we did the elephant, and I happened to just do the drawing in the class, whereas in the session with you all, we all did the drawing. But I got time to color, and I have a color over here to share it with you how it did it turn, and it will be uploaded soon. So don't worry, those who want to color yesterday's elephant paint drawing can do the painting as well, taking the reference. So here I will show you my version here. Yes, any questions, we will come to that. I will show you the version of painting that we did in elephant. So this elephant we drew in the previous class, and this is how it turned out to be. Keeping the Independence Day in mind, I did the border with green and orange. So this is giving a little touch to that and major colors on that. So I hope you all like it, but if in case you wish to do the painting on it, the reference will be shared in the on the channel. Okay. Oh, thank you so much. Thank you. Thank you that you liked it. Today we are going to do another painting, and we are going to do a horse. I will show a small section of the painting, and because our 1 hour session is not enough for the full drawing, detailing, and painting, everything to be done in 1 hour, we'll do the drawing, and the later the coloring part, you can always check as whatever day it is as a part two. So that will help you with the coloring part. Yeah, it is a very royal white elephant. Okay, so to ease the time and the thing I have done, I've taken a paper and I drew the border on it. I drew the border on three sides, and it's not that I would not be telling. I left one side so that I can give you the idea of how to draw such curvy borders. They look very complicated, but they are not. Yes, elephant can be green color, white color, blue color, any color. There is no problem in that. You can do pink color, any color. It doesn't go by the coloring. I just wanted to keep it white, and with high contrast in maroon, I kept it that way. You can do anything. So here, I have taken. I'll just adjust the camera a little so that you get the whole view. Probably now it's the better. So here. So I have done three sides of this, and I will simplify it on the fourth side. How to do this drawing? So I took the A4 size paper, and my pen is a drawing pen, and it is a waterproof and a fade proof pen. And here I will be drawing this directly. So this is a curvy design and is a part of our freehand drawing. So in this, so if we are all ready, we can start. So here I am just making the curves halfway because it has to go swirling like this. How do we differentiate? We will be just doing one curve half, leave some space, do another curve. This is how I would be doing my picture. So here, this is a very simplified way of doing catching over any picture. So this is my track of my whale. Oh, thank you, Mehak. Thank you. Now here we will do the double outline, and then I will here double outline, and I'm giving it a loop over here like a cover. Like that. I'll go ahead and give the loop over here as well. So I'm just doubling and adding a knot to it. You, if in case it's not connected, do not worry. So I'll just lower it down so that you get a better view of it here. Okay, Prabha, please answer. Can we do a border on our own thinking? Yes, of course. It has to abide by the rules of this Kalamkari art. So there are certain types of popular designs as well. You can always try any form, any shape, any style. Experiments are always welcome. So here you may. I'm just showing what I did. If in case somebody wants to just replicate this, it will be easier for you to follow. So this is how I make it. So here, a double outline. I missed this part. A double outline and this kind of a border. Here, from wherever this knot is, I will be turning this kind of a shape. We have worked with this in many of our pictures and it's very simple. So here, now again, it's turning over here. I will be going on the other side. So if you go one by one, it's going to get very, very easy. This is one, and here I'm doing another one followed by a leaf. So the leaf, I'm just making a little curvier leaf like this, and this occupies all the space that has been taken here. Here also, I will be doing one to give the, if the space is less, you can make a little variation of the leaf. That is totally okay. Even in one design, you may have a slight difference. What color you use to paint the elephant? I did not paint the elephant. I did other parts with acrylic paint, and the elephant was just paper white. So where it is white, I just kept it as paper. So here I will be just making the space filling with that curvy leaf. And this is how this gets full. If in case you feel that some places there are spaces left, you can fill with such designs. Fill up a little more. So even if you just go one by one on the step, even a difficult one would come easy. Like this. corners, you have to just adjust yourself. And here I'm giving the space, filling like this, connecting all the small. And this is the bottom. So this, I just kept one side so that I can do with all of you while I completed the other sides, all to save the time. And this is the bottom. Now we'll go ahead and make the horse. In my previous drawing also, I took pencil to draw the basic shape first and then. So here I will be making my way of doing it. So I'm just making a one circle here to for the front of the body, then the lower side of the body, connect it, and here this is the basic form. That's the horse is going to be the head. I'll just make it here, and the tail over here. One leg here and the other here. So this is a rough sketch of it. I will just finalize the whole picture with the pen. So definitely we are not making these circles, as these are just the graphing of it. So I'll just go ahead and give the outline to the picture. I would not be outlining because I just made it like a stick figure. I just made one. So. And I'll give it a seat over here. Later we will do the detailing. Of course, a beautiful tail. You can give the bounds that look beautiful. And with this, it's a very rough thing, but I would be doing it fair right now. Thank you so much, everyone. Thanks for the compliments. Here. And now here I'm just connecting to this part. This is being the other side of the being the other side. I'll just keep it like this. And all the circles I'll just not do because these are just the body form. Here I'll just focus on the so the hooves, and this here I would make a nice muscular body. So the basic form of the animal stays the same, not too much. Only the ornamentation gets a little towards the style of Kalamkari. I'll make two ears. Very alert. Here, I happen to go a little far from this, so the I'll have to fix this. Now, I will be telling you if something happens like this, what will you do on the paper? So, I have a jelly roll pen here. So, if in case sudden things like these happen at places, I just take my jelly roll white and I just do it over the line. And then it gets hidden. So, it's not that your whole picture is gone wrong if in case you happen to meet with an accident. Like suppose I kept my hand over here while the ink was still wet. So I will just retouch it and then the fixing is done. So such things for that corrections. This is a white. You may use a white ink, white anything. So I'll have to wait till it dries. And now I will be starting with the picture. So I'll go ahead and erase all the rough lines that are there so that we are good to go for the final touch. I'll still not touch my white pen area that I did. And this is, oops, I erased the pen. So here we are ready, and now we will do the decoration of in a Kalamkari style. So Kalamkari, we have all the small designs as we did it for the elephant also. We will do it for this. Thank you, Mehak. For the tail, we'll just put lines. So we'll just make multiple lines because how could we show the hair? Your lines may cross because then the volume of it is not the same. And they may start at a different place also. So it's not that it has to follow the same line. This. We will paint a little. It will come. So whenever, if in case it you feel that a drawing gets a little difficult, the best thing to form something is, first my advice if you are just beginning is try with a pencil. When you will hold a pencil, you are always a little more confident. You'll not feel that scared that you will spoil a work, right? You draw basic line pattern. You see that, okay, the spacing is left nice, the body proportions, the limbs, everything is falling in the place, angle of the head, fine, and everything is fine. Then you can start inking your project. Now here, all the details will start. I will start with the seat here. Now, as we repeatedly do these lines, we all know that these are very common in this. If I happen to do a seat, it comes very instantly what all we want to do. You will get it with the practice. Right now, you can just follow. So for a Webley, this is the back of a little seat. And these things are all seen for the design. Just the decoration of the horse. We are going to make this also as a royal, nice horse. Now the small smaller designs, and here I'll just do the tassel. Even for yes, as said, yes, mehdi designs, yes, in India we all many of us put henna and then we do the henna, but now in henna also we have started putting horses with brides and grooms, so that's another scenario. But yeah, veils and flowers, and these are a part of henna, not the Marwari style, for the Arabic style of henna, these veils and patterns are very commonly seen. So even if we talk about henna, there are various ways, various styles of henna. So if you are doing Arabic henna, nothing that is lively, life has like. But in Indian style, when we do the Marwari style, we'll make all the brides, grooms, elephants, horse, barat, everything. We'll make that procession, everything. But in Arabic, that is a no. We do not make anything that is like this. So giving some bands over here. Whenever you are making two of the legs overlapping, always see to it that the line doesn't go in continuation. Otherwise, the visual will be disturbed. Like, we want to show that these are two different legs in motion. So then these lines, it's not going to go all the way from one to other. Do it one portion at a time, and this will give you better perception of the thing here. Just the belts for the saddle. I'm doing the same design that we did it in the borders also. It will all go as the mane, the hair or the decoration. Yes, it does. Mango shape, parsley shape, the basic shapes that are there are very curvy. And it's not that it is. It is very much similar to the Persian art, that is. So I'm just making the ear. And the decoration. For the horses, we see that there is this decoration on the head as well. A small eye. So this is pretty much. For the hair also, I will do a little more decoration here. And today we would paint also. So we'll just do a little section probably. So all your doubts about the paints will be answered today. Basic shapes, I'll just, if we have time, we'll be just going ahead and tell you a few of the basic shapes in a class. So just, we cannot do a very big design in this, otherwise the beauty of the horse will be gone. We'll do few little things so that it comes out, and then we will be doing a certain background as well. So we'll do. If you have not subscribed the channel, I wish you subscribe and support. So, and those who have already did, thank you so much. Here again, all the tassels on this, because they are all being tied. Now a very beautiful big decorating piece on the chest of it here. So this is, marked it. I'm going to do the design over here. Sahaj breathe. Okay, how, ma'am, how we draw these motifs on canvas? On the canvas also, if you have canvas, I would suggest you use a color pencil. In case you want to draw it on the canvas, when you do it with graphite and you try to erase it off, it is very difficult. So just take a neutral color pencil, or if preferably a water-based pencil, so that once you paint, it is all settled and it doesn't shine. Try taking a brown or a yellow, that will merge, and later you will be doing your black lines. Once your drawing is done, then you can start inking it, as in you would not be drawing the design. You can put the paint in the leaf, and later with the acrylic pens also we get. If you want to try the acrylic pens, you can do the outline with the acrylic pen. If in case you do not have acrylic pen, you can take a brush and acrylic paint and do the black outlines. Outlines are all time black in Kalamkari. So that is how we do for the canvas. Canvas, if not primed, you have to prime it with a gesso. If it is primed, you can go ahead and do it directly. If in case you are not very confident drawing on a canvas with pencil or color pencil, whatever, then you do it on a picture. If suppose this picture is there, you can get a trace copy of it, a sheet. And how would you trace? You can always put a carbon paper and do it. Carbon paper comes in different colors. Preferably take a brown color or a yellow color carbon paper, not blue. The blue carbon paper gives a lot of blue ink, which spoils other colors. So very important thing to remember is that the color of the carbon should be yellow or brown while you are tracing your artworks. Thank you, Hina. Just going a little curvy on this design. Freehand. And just fill up this. We will just do some hangings down. Some ruffles or cloth. So this is just the horse. Now we will go ahead and do the background, as in like a little bit on the bottom. I'll just do a little bit of on the down, not on the top. So here, going again with the same kind of design, because that is kind of staple for this picture. So one going down, one going on the top, and in the center I'm going to do a beautiful flower. So this way, I'll just take a little on this side and on this side. Wherever the spacing is, I would not be putting it across the main subject of the picture. Now, depending on the place, you can make it small or big. I don't want it to cross it really, but just a little, and that's it. I don't want to do more on that. This doesn't allow me to put that much of design, so these veins are good enough. Here I have a beautiful place where I can just spread a little more and do more. A bigger design. Like this. When we do the coloring of the picture, now this is a pretty piece that is done. I will be hanging some vines on the top as well, because it's going to look very blank if I color the background. So one and two. In our previous thing that we did, we also did the valance in our peacock, I guess. Yes, in the peacock drawing we did this thing, but it was very different. We did the valance view of them. Here I'm going to do a different one. All the leaves. So basically, we just visualize the same shape of the leaf, but we go on the curves. Here, I will be doing flowers. So this could be one over here. It's not the sun. Do not feel that it's the sun, because generally that's the position we do the sun. You may choose any background that you want to. In many cases, we just leave it blank and we just do some flowers like this. That's it. Maybe some festival, something, or any other. I will just take a paper and show you a few of the filling designs if in case you're interested. So, since I made one, I'll have to now cover all of it, and it doesn't matter, it looks beautiful anyway. So, here. I really don't know the price of the pen, you will have to check. You may do big, small, whichever way you want. That is all acceptable. I have we have to use same pattern in any for any design. No, you may change. There are so many patterns. When you will be doing the class, the sessions here, you will see that there are different patterns. Now, here I have taken another one. In the previous one, in the previous, that was yesterday's painting, we did this border. So this border is there, and now you see how we have colored it. You can use it one color for all, or I have just kept it in two colors. The whole theme of my picture is this tan color, orange and brown mixed together, and maroon green. So basically, if you see, it is yellow, orange, green, and maroon. That's the that those are the only colors used. So it's not very multicolored. It is following the scheme of the colors, right? But for the patterns, you can use any pattern, but the basic shapes that we follow in Kalamkari, we will be doing that. If in case that is one thing that you would want, you may write it, or if in case need be, I will just do one video and post it on the basic shapes that are basic curves, basic shapes that are there for this art. The coloring tutorial of the last day's work, of the previous day's work, Saturday's session, will be uploaded today. Any painting that you do can be skipped the above part. You may always, it is your painting and you do it the way you want to do it, or whichever way you want to place it. So anything can be skipped, or if in case you want to add more, you can just do that. So this is pretty much for this picture, and I will start to paint a little section of it so that you get the idea of how to paint it. Now for painting, I just take the acrylic paints, and these are the colors. You get it in the box, you'll get it as a set of 12, but apart from that you get a lot of paints, a lot of colors. If you want to go elaborate, you can buy out of the box colors also. And the price of these, if in case you are eager, the price of it is 20 rupees. So in India, it is for 20 bucks. So this, the brushes that I use are the rounded synthetic brush. Any brand is okay, but you have to be careful that the tip should be fine and it should not be frayed. Okay, so take fine brushes, because for the lining purpose, you would need a fine brush. So here you will need a plate to mix your color. Many of the people who practice acrylic paint often come up with I'll do the basic shape class. I'll note it and I'll do it. So always take a mixing plate. Mixing plate is very important, because what happens when we do the painting in the background, people come up with that the paint is not coming smooth, the lines are being seen. So if in case the lines are being seen, then what to do? Sometimes when we open the bottle and just keep it and start with just the bottle dipping in and washing your brush and then again dipping, sometimes the amount of water that is in the brush affects the polymers of the acrylic paint, and they might split and they become more transparent. So if you want to do a very opaque and nice one, take whatever paint you want. So here, if I'm taking, I'll take the dark one and the light one both, so that you get the idea. I'll take the dark, and I'm taking Persian blue. This is my Persian blue. I will take little, not too much. Just take little. How much ever you think that you are going to use, take it. Now, I will be mixing a little bit of water. Acrylic paints are, they also come in the bottles and they also come in the tubes. Any form is okay. The tube ones are a little thick and these are little liquid. So I've taken one drop of water and I will just make a smooth paste. I'm taking a little thick brush. This number is, I think, 4. And I will take a thin as well for my fine areas. So here I have my brush. I'll just take a fine point brush, liner brush. So you will see that the tip of this brush is even thin. Just take nice, load your brush nicely, and I'll go ahead for the border. Yes, Surekha, you joined in now. It's okay, but yes, the session is up, will be uploaded and available to watch on YouTube. So here I'm just doing the outline first. You have to be very careful, because this is very curvy design and has very fine areas to deal with, like this. So you have to reload. Never use a rough brush or a dry brush, because your lines will get frayed. So take nice paint and now in the center you can just go a little. Once your paint is laid, you will see that some places when you are taking the paint and doing it, you will have the lumps. So now is the time when you will just make all the painted area as little smooth. So give it a refined touch so that you do not get difference in the paint. So now it is very smooth. loading of your brush should be consistent. Consistent as in every time you load the same amount of paint. Do not go for, okay, mixing a little more water in some areas and then. So if your paint is the same way, your painting will come the same way. The only thing is, definitely once we put our brush down for the first time, the paint is more. And when you sweep it, the paint will get less. So try to pick on the area where you have piled up more and sweep it. And this is how you will be able to get uniform painting. So here, I'll just do a little section of this just so that we get the idea. We'll do small sections and probably we'll just post it, the full version of it. So I'm using my thin brush and it is zero. If you feel, when you will be doing it, you will realize that after doing some section, whatever paint you have taken out in your palette is also dry. Then you might, when you see that the smoothness is not enough, then you may want to add a little bit of water to it to get to the same consistency, the previous consistency. Because once the paints are open, they do dry. So you have to refix it. So I'm just doing this. I will just leave this portion here and I will go on to the next color. So here, I'll just wash my brush and probably for the background over here, I'll keep my horse. I would wish to keep both the animals the same way, the white, and I might frame it together. Can we use color pen in place of acrylic colors? Yes, you may. We get brush pens and you may use the brush pens. We get Copic markers also. You can use Copic markers. Try to keep yourself more on the traditional kind of shapes. So blue is a color from the indigo and we see that in all the paintings which are organically obtained colors. So we can go with this. If in case I want to do it orange, what I do is I mix it with a little brown to show it a little more organic and a subtle shade. Acrylic paints and brush become rough and sticky. Do we clean our brushes? Please keep all your brushes very, very clean and store them nicely. I would say acrylic, if acrylic dries on your brush, it dries permanent and then you will spoil your brush. So now I'll go for orange probably. Orange and blue will make a good combination and I'll go for the background as orange. One more thing, while you are painting your blues and you plan to do your leaves, do not do when it is still wet. There are pretty good chances that the color, you might just slip off your brush on the other side and the color will spoil it. So let it dry and then you go on to the other side of it. So here I just took orange. I'll just show a little bit section of it. And here I'll show, generally these lines will occur on the bigger areas. So to cover the bigger areas, make good amount of paint and use a thicker brush, broader brush, because reason being, when we work very slow, our paint absorbs in the paper first thing, and then it is difficult to pull it. So it gets the dark color. A smooth coat will always help you. So here it has to be smooth. Pull all the extra color that is there and work in one direction. So while you're working in one direction, I'll just show you one more trick that is very, very helpful while you do the backgrounds. So if in case I've applied it and some people will just go random and fine, filling up fast. Then the next step that can be done is take a dry brush. Take a dry brush and just rub it over. See to it that the brush is clean. I don't know if mine is or not. Yes, it is. So just go and rub it off all the pileups and then you will get a smooth one. So this is one thing that you can rework quickly. So touching with a dry brush will make it all smooth. So that is another trick. Yes, Rishit, you can make a tree. In the previous picture, we've made a tree here. So yesterday we've already covered a tree for this picture. So we are just keeping it to this one. So not to repeat it. Your choice, you can go. When it is complete painted. Yes, of course, I will post the picture there. When it is done, I'm just showing it to you in the class. For if in case you have any questions, you can write your doubts. I can work in front of you and tell you how to eliminate those flaws. So here, just if in case, I'm just in a rush. Generally, people are so like piling up like this. Okay, what happens? So, first of all, be very gentle. It won't take much time. Okay. Going smooth. But what if in case, if I hold it closer to the camera, you will see that the paint is piled up. I don't know if it's visible, right? But if in case that has already happened, this trick is very handy. Take a dry brush and sweep it off so that it gives a leveled color. Okay, that is how we will go on to the, and we will not go all around. We'll just go from one corner and then we'll cover it up. Using brush paints, sure, I will keep my brush paints one day and then I will show you how to use brushes. In one of the sessions, I've used poster color also. Now, this is when I'm just telling you about the acrylics, because many of the questions are that acrylic, they don't get uniform color with acrylic. So these are the tricks. You can work with acrylic and you'll get good color. So this is how, again, just retouch yourself with the dry one and then you are good to go. There are no flaws in this and it is coming very, very even. So whichever way I hold it, you won't be able to see any brush lines. So this is a good way of covering your picture. I will be covering the whole of it and I will be posting it on the channel. So you will see the coloring tutorial as well, where I will be mixing few of the shades. That is also a very important thing. How do we make subtle shades? Any questions that anybody has on this picture, you can ask me. I'll be available and answer you. In the next session, do not miss the next session, we will be doing the faces. So we have covered our nature of it. I will be posting a video on the basic shapes, as somebody has posted that they want a tutorial on basic shapes that are acceptable in this, because basic shapes can be lines and patterns and geometrical patterns as well. But this Kalamkari art doesn't go by the geometric patterns as much. So what all shapes are more acceptable and give a better flavor to this picture or any other Kalamkari picture, I will be doing that and posting it. Any questions apart from the basic shapes that you want and the animals we covered this week, we have covered animals. The previous week we covered birds. Now, next week we will be doing the faces, how to make the Kalamkari faces. That's a very beautiful thing. Hi, Lalita. Okay, so any questions on this? Else we will be closing the session for today and I'll see you next week at 3 o'clock. We have to do painting only on canvas paper. Can we use cardboard and GSM canvas? Okay, while you are painting it on the cardboard canvas, you can paint it anywhere. you canvas you will get a primed canvas. If in case you are doing it on the paper, you can do it on the handmade paper, you can do it on the acrylic sheet, you can do it on the cartridge paper, bond paper, any paper. But if you are using paints, it has to be a little thick. But if you are doing it on a cardboard, you must prime it first, because cardboard, generally we get not a very good quality cardboard, and once you do the painting, the brown color of the cardboard comes up to the so cardboard. If in case you are planning, do double coat of gesso over it, and then you start. You can do it on MDF, plastic, wood, anything, anything. Yes, parrots we will cover. Parrots we will do it. I'll note it down for that. Parrots and peacocks are the most seen things. Sure, I will post all the videos and all the things pertaining to Kalamkari. So this course by the end will take you to each and everything. You will get the idea of so many borders, so many shapes, so many whales, flowers, everything. Animals, birds, humans, figures, dancers, everything you will get, so that you are comfortable in this art form and you can start doing that. Okay. So after we finish off with this, we will pick up on to another art form. But for now, it's only Kalamkari. So we are just going on with Kalamkari. We'll announce. Please follow me on my Facebook page. So all the announcements of the further workshops will be done there. As after Kalamkari, what is going to be our next one? We will schedule it and we post it on the on my Facebook page. And that is the best way you can keep a tack on what is going to happen. Okay, thank you all for your valuable time. And I will see you next week. Till then, be creative and do Kalamkari. Bye-bye, everyone. Take care.